Okay.
Okay, so good evening. I'm here with Tig of Tig's Irish Bar and Restaurant.
Good evening.
Which is the home of craft beer in Kyoto. Tell us how many beers do you have on tap?
I've been Japanese and imported American and European beers. There's 23 beers on tap.
You have 23 taps.
23 taps. Good international beers and top class award-winning Japanese beers.
How many beers are from actually from Kyoto?
At the moment we have only one on tap at the moment, but there are new beers coming on stream. There's also a new brewery opening up within the next year in Kyoto as well.
In Kyoto? How many breweries are there in Kyoto?
There's two main breweries in Kyoto. One is Susan Kaido, and they've sort of cornered the market as far as draft craft beer is concerned. The other one is called Machia Beer, and they're more bottled beer. They're still learning. They have a way to go yet.
They're the ones that do the Kelch and the Amber Ale.
That's right.
Yeah, I like those. Okay, so what else was I going to ask you? Oh yes, you do a lot of craft beer events. Can you tell us something about those?
Usually, what we do here in the bar proper is we select a Japanese craft beer company, and we get them to send five or six of their seasonal brews. And what we do is, on a Saturday or a Sunday, we do an event from around 1 o'clock in the day where we charge a low price for the beer and also for the food as well. And what this does, it entices people to come in and experience more of a variety of craft beer, because craft beer 2 kilo is a very, very new thing. We also get the brewers or the owners of the brewery to come and explain their craft and how to get a different taste and what are the different types of beer. And this is very important. And also very exciting for us as well to experience new beers and seasonal beers that are coming on tap on.
Would you say craft beer is trending in Kyoto?
In Osaka most certainly, and Tokyo has really boomed, especially in the past 5 years. In the past 2 years, a huge amount of bars have opened in Osaka. We are just at the cusp here of the craft beer market. It's a small, it's in its infancy at the moment, but there is a trend and it's growing. But with the new influx of new bars, it will all, because I reckon that the incoming tide raises all boats, it will make more people aware, and especially with the events, there's also a couple of Kyoto specialized craft beer events where they get 20 or 30 breweries to come in and bring different types of beer, and that's been attended by tens of thousands of people both in autumn and in spring. So it is definitely on the rise, but it will take another little bit of time.
Okay. Can I ask you finally, there's a lot of Irish pubs in Kyoto, but this is the only one that has this many craft beers. You've really dedicated yourself to craft beer culture. What is it? Why is it that you decided to make that decision? Because it's quite a big step to focus so much on your business on this one thing. What appealed to you?
Well, what appealed to me is a few years ago, when I came there first, it was mostly Japanese generic beers, and most of them tasted the same, and some of them actually tasted pretty horrible. But Mino Beer, which is one of the first craft brewers to open up in the Kansai area, they came out with an incredible WIPA back, you know, maybe 9 years ago. And it was absolutely astonishing. And I saw this, and with these great events that they had in the Osaka Dome, that they still have in the Osaka Dome, I went to a few of these and said, well, this is, you know, it's an extra string to the bow as well, because in this economic climate, which there is a bit of a downturn, you know, you have to be able to offer your customers, you know,
something unique,
and also something with added value as well. So we see this as a way of, you know, having something very, very wonderful, but also something very, very unique as well here in Kyoto.
Thank you, Tig.
My pleasure, mate.
Thanks, Tig.